Mary Pickford.
It's a... Mary Pickford. A blacksmith sign. I wonder if it's from Doc's old shop.
Intruding, madam. We were wondering if you could tell us...
I don't talk to hooligans!
Not a very friendly sort.
That was Edna.
Edna Strickland? Impossible.
This is how she was when I first met her. I had to... Listen, just leave it to me.
Okay, you think you know how to handle her. Just remember, we need to know what happened to Hill Valley, and just as importantly, the precise time when it happened.
Edna's grandfather, Marshall Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment, way back, in the future. Hey, Miss Strick...
Who are you?
Marty McFly.
That's a foolish name. And I make it a rule not to talk to strangers with foolish names.
But we're not strangers.
How do I know you?
You interviewed me once, back when you were young.
Listen, Sonny, I'm an easygoing woman, but I got a few rules I live by. And rule number one is, I never, ever talk about the past! Nor the future, neither. I don't talk about any day but today.
I guess that didn't go so well.
Of course she doesn't talk about the past, because there's something in her past she's trying to forget. But we're gonna pry it out of her. Go ahead, knock on the door again.
What?
It's me again, your old friend.
How do I know you?
We spent the day together.
We did? Where?
At the expo.
That's crazy. I've been here all... What day is it?
Tuesday, October 13th, 1931.
October 13th, 1931. October 13th. Something funny about that date. Well, what are you here for?
Come on, Miss Strickland.
Miss who?
Strickland. You're Edna Strickland.
Take a look at the mailbox, Sonny. Name's Pickford. Mary Pickford. And it has been for as long as I care to remember. And like I told you, I don't care to remember!
Listen, lady, you've got to tell us where Hill Valley went.
Hill Valley? You're standing in Hill Valley. Population one.
You know there's supposed to be a town here today, right?
Might be there was a town once long ago, or might be it was in the future. How many times I gotta tell you, I don't talk about any time but today!
You see that car over there? You stole that from Carl Sagan, and you time-jumped into the past.
Me? Steal a car? You got a lot of nerve, Sonny. Everyone in town knows that Mary Pickford's the most law-abiding citizen that Hill Valley's ever had. And I don't give a fig about the past.
I brought something for you.
What is it? Let me see. System. Thanks.
I brought you these tickets to the expo.
What expo?
The expo you left when you swiped the DeLorean and jumped back in time.
Stop messing with my brain. I don't know nothing about time travel, and I never did. And what's more, I never talk about the past!
I brought you this.
Already got one.
I brought you this.
I ain't interested in flowers.
Wait till you hear.
And I especially ain't interested in talking flowers. Put them away.
We must have brought something Edna wants.
Don't look at me. I didn't bring anything but myself.
I wonder what's cooking. I guess this isn't the right time to be burning things. Ouch! You've got a nice cactus here.
Quit beating around the bush! I ain't got all day!
I'm guessing this mop doesn't get much use. I can wait. I'm sure I can get her to talk to me.
Then what are you waiting for? Knock on the door.
An old saloon sign. Cool. Too bad it's all burnt. I don't think so. Ouch! Ouch! Edna's grandfather, Marshall Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment. Way back, in the future. I brought something for you.
What is it? Let me see.
I brought you this.
Already got one.
I brought you this.
Already got one.
Maybe not. Not sure what that'll do. Not sure what that'll do. I'm sure I can get her to talk to me.
Then what are you waiting for? Knock on the door.
I brought something for you.
What is it? Let me see.
I brought you him.
Him? Ho him. Him ho.
This is Doc Brown, the guy who built the car you stole.
Stole? I never steal. I'm a law-abiding citizen. Still, there is something familiar about those features. Sure I don't know you from somewhere?
Sure you remember him. Carl Sagan, the guy you framed as a speakeasy arsonist.
Speakeasy? Arson? That's complete gibberish, Sonny. Whatever you're talking about's got nothing to do with me. I never involve myself in such criminal shenanigans. Still, his features remind me of someone.
Look hard. Don't tell me you don't recognize your own boyfriend.
My boyfriend?
Yeah, he's all grown up.
Come closer, fella.
Marty. What am I supposed to do?
Trust me, Doc. Just go with it.
It can't be! Emmett!
Yes, Edna. It's me.
It is! It's October 13th, 1931! Oh, and you are Emmett! Emmett! Oh, how did I get so turned around? Have I been dreaming, or... Well, stay there!
It's a classic case of repressed memory syndrome. Once the mental dam is broken, the subject is immediately plunged into the midst of the very scenes she's trying to forget.
Darling, you've come back. Of course I knew you would. An intelligent boy like you wouldn't be one to throw away true love all because of a silly quarrel. I've already forgotten about last night's little tiff. I trust you've done the same?
Of course I have.
Of course I have. What?
Schnookums.
Schnookums.
You're sweet. But you're still keeping company with this Smirnoff character. I insist you drop him. He's a bad influence. And you've got to stop working on that dangerous electrokinetic... What's this?
Okay.
I suppose now you're miffed with me for forcing Detective Parker to close your booth down. Bitter medicine for you, I know, but I had to do it. And Parker had no choice but to obey my orders. He knows that my opinion carries a lot of weight in Hill Valley, and he'd never... Parker would never... Oh!
What is it?
I don't know. Something about Detective Parker. Something that happened to me on October 13th. What could it be?
Can you jog her memory? If we can keep her mind in the past, we may get the full story of Hill Valley's premature destruction.
Here's something that'll make you remember.
Remember what? I don't like to remember. Who are you? What are you doing in my yard, you hooligan?
No, Edna. No yard.
What?
This is Emmett speaking. It's October 13th, 1931.
Yes.
And something's about to happen.
Oh, yes, something big. But what?
Better not talk to her directly. It'll break the spell.
I hate to see it like this.
Was framed. Oh, he's after me! Ha! He'll never catch me in this souped-up car of the future. Curses! I can't shake him. Well, no use in holding back now. Let's see what this baby can do. And here it comes.
Yes.
Here what comes?
I don't know. Something. Really, unexpected is supposed to happen right about now, but I'm not sure what. Oh, come to think of it, how can I be expecting something unexpected? What's going on?
Quick, Marty. We've got to find a way to push the story along before she snaps out of her reverie.
Sure what that'll do.
Oh, get out! Get out! Get out!
Don't upset her, Marty.
I guess this isn't the right time to be burning things.
Heavens! Can it be? It is!
Is what?
Grandfather! Big as life!
Marshal James Strickland came to Hill Valley in 1869, shot by...
I know, Doc. We met him in 1885. Remember?
No! I must be mistaken. Grandfather didn't look like that. That man is an imposter! I'm not even sure it is a man! This is all very confusing. Where am I? Why am I thinking about the past? Get off my lawn, you kids!
Better find a way to bring back Marshal Strickland quick. We've got to bring this story to a climax.
Edna's grandfather, Marshal Strickland. That's the same picture I saw in Edna's apartment, way back, in the future. Sure what that'll do.
Oh, get out! Get out! Get out!
Don't upset her, Marty.
I guess this isn't the right time to be burning things.
This hat doesn't frame her face very well. Nice fit. Looks like a Strickland to me.
Like my little brother, perhaps, but not like my grandfather. Grandfather was much more, shaggy. Grandfather, how well you look. How well everything looks.
How does everything look? Tell me.
It's a bit rustic, to be sure, but all the buildings are so sturdy and well kept, and the young people of Hill Valley, they're so virtuous and upright. So unlike the degenerate specimens from the 20th century, and I know the reason why.
Why?
They haven't yet fallen prey to the vices of booze and debauchery. They are still in a state of innocence. I think I could learn to like living here. But who's this?
Who?
This big lout swaggering up the street, lips curled in an insolent sneer. He's a newcomer to Hill Valley. Beauregard. Beauregard...
Tannen.
Yes!
Good guess.
Look at him. Acting like a big shot. Throwing his money around. Stolen money, no doubt. Why can't they see through him? The two-bit phony! And now his plan becomes clear. He's bought a plot of land in town. He's going to put up a...
A what?
I don't know. It's something I don't like. Something evil.
This is the key to our mystery. We've got to get her memory back in the groove.
It's an old saloon sign. Looks like it's been through a few bar fights. Maybe this will take you back.
Back where? I don't want to go back.
Stay in the moment, Edna. Please, Marty, don't interrupt the trance.
Not sure what that'll do. sure what that'll do.
Talk about a watering hole.
A saloon? In Hill Valley? Oh, he can't do that! Grandpa, you can't let him do it! You can't let that snake ruin paradise! Well, if they're all too blind to stop him, I'll just have to take the law into my own hands. I'll make sure this sinful establishment never opens its doors. I don't know what I'll do, but I'll do something. Something very conclusive. No, you're doing it all wrong. It'll never burn like that. First, we'll need some kerosene. Apply it liberally to the building site. No sense in being parsimonious. And now, watch. Isn't it beautiful? The devil's handiwork consumed by the fires of righteousness! Burn, you sucker!
She was never this passionate when we were dating. What is it then? Is it the fire?
Turn away! Don't look!
It's not staying in the saloon, is it? It's spreading to the other buildings in Hill Valley.
My intentions were pure. It wasn't supposed to happen like this.
But it did happen like this. And you've been repressing it all these years because you can't stand to admit that you're
a hooligan. I'm a hooligan!
Did I lay it on too thick?
Here's the story. Black and white and red all over.
Huh. Hill Valley destroyed by fire. Started approximately 2 a.m. July 17th, 1876!
Of course, I'm not the real criminal in this story, am I, Mr. Sagan? You set me up for a fall, you and Smirnoff. You made me steal your infernal car. You made me burn down Hill Valley. And now, by the powers invested in me by the town of Hill Valley, I hereby sentence you two criminals to... You! How much have you heard?
Enough for a month's worth of headlines in the Hayesville Herald. 2 months worth if you shoot those fellas.
I could shoot you too, you know.
But you won't, because that would be against the law. And you never break the law, right? This is your cue to skedaddle.
Right.
Much obliged. There's Beauregard Tannen's half-finished saloon. Sometime during the next hour, Edna's going to light it on fire and accidentally burn down Hill Valley.
I wonder where her DeLorean is.
We'll find it later. Right now, we've got to stop that fire. I'll go around back, you go through the front.
Got it. I think I liked it better on the outhouse door. I'd better not get too close. Not sure what that'll do. I'd better not get too close.
Edna, stop. It's just me.
Mr. Sagan, what are you doing here?
I was gonna ask you the same question, Miss Pickford.
Isn't it obvious? I'm putting an end to your den of iniquity before it starts.
I don't think so, Mary. I don't like shooting women, but no one comes between Beauregard B. Tannen and his livelihood.
Tannen, stop! If you shoot her, she'll drop the torch and this whole place will burn up. Edna, stop! If you drop that torch, he'll shoot us!
Looks like we're at something of a standoff here, Mr. Tannen.
I don't see a way out, unless somebody manages to disarm both of you at the same time.
How the hell am I supposed to do that?
Was that a mouse?
What's the matter, Miss Pickford? Scared of a little mouse?
No, but you should be scared. Mice carry diseases. It's a fact. Look it up.
Dolores Miskin?
Why are you so hellfire determined to meddle in my affairs, woman? You've been a-burrin' my behind for over a month now.
You're the source of the hellfire around here, Tannen. I'm just fanning the flames a little.
Lady, I'm just giving the hard-working folk of Hill Valley a place to place.
Chandeliers right over their heads. That's gotta be useful somehow. Not sure what that'll do. Cripes, it's no wonder the town went up. I can smell the kerosene from here. Maybe I could jump him.
Are you here to haul me back to 1931 for my supposed crimes? Or is there some sort of time court for that kind of thing?
Time court? Wouldn't the
Not sure what that'll do. Gotta find some way to snuff out Edna's torch without getting her and Doc killed.
What kind of odds would you give me that I can disarm you and douse the young lady's torch simultaneously?
About the same odds that you can walk out of here.
Pickle juice. That ought to be handy for putting out torches. It's too heavy to lift.
Man, this thing is not light. It's right over his head, but I can't knock him out while Edna's still holding that torch.
100 years from now, he'll...
Not sure what that'll do. I can't reach it. And even if I could knock it down, Edna would be free to torch the place.
Man, this thing is not light.
Maybe we can come to a more peaceable solution, Mr. Tannen.
Keep your distance, Fancy Pants. I don't know you from Adam, but that won't stop me from putting you in a box.
Pickle juice. That ought to be handy for putting out torches. It's too heavy to lift.
I wonder what's in these.
Oh, stop, quiet! God.
What the hell? Oh, cow crap! There goes all my pickled pig's feet!
Down.
Looks like your torch is getting a little dim there, Miss Pickford.
It's still hot enough to bring down this little bit of Gamora, Tannen.
All right, physics.
Why are you dressed like that?
I wasn't planning on visiting the 19th century today.
And I wasn't planning on shooting a couple of lunatics today. Guess life's full of surprises, ain't it?
Say, that's a lovely.
What was that noise?
What noise? I didn't hear a noise. Mary Pickford?
Okay, that was lucky.
Won't be long now.
We'll just see.
The ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
Not sure what that'll do.
ammo's in place. Now to pull the trigger.
Maybe we can come to a more peaceable solution, Mr. Tannen.
Keep your distance, Fancy Pants. I don't know you from Adam.
Not sure what that'll do.
Got any last words?
I'll see you in hell, Tannen.
You first, lady.
Come on, you son of a...
Ha! The frog!
Who the hell are you?
I'm the diversion, butthead.
Nice one, Doc.
Don't tell Clara. She thinks Fisticuffs set a bad example for the boys. Now, where's Edna?
Doc, she's gone. Edna's DeLorean.
We've got to stop her before she hits 88 miles per hour. Come on!
Okay, Edna, nothing to be worried about. You're a smart woman with a strong moral compass. You just need to think your way out of it. Oh, fudge!
What's she doing?
I think she's spouting euphemisms at us. Luckily, the road out of Hill Valley is still pretty rough in 1875. It's unlikely she'll manage to accelerate 88 miles an hour anytime soon.
How are we gonna stop her?
Good question. We can't risk injuring her or damaging the vehicle for fear of altering the timeline even further. Luckily, those diagnostic lights my altered self went all over with DeLorean have given me an idea. Here, take these.
What are these?
Flux synchronization modules.
How do they work?
I generally use them for maintenance purposes. We might be able to use them to sync up with the alternate drawings' diagnostic modules, thus making it possible to link both sets of time circuits and override the time destination of the alternate DeLorean. At least that's the theory, anyway.
That's a great plan, I think.
Best of all, we won't need to weld the modules to the frame. Snap them over the diagnostic lights.
Wait a minute, Doc. You want me to go out there? How the heck am I supposed to do that?
Good question. Let me think.
Aha! A hoverboard!
It saved our hides a few times before, so it seemed like the appropriate tool to bring along for the job.
Sweet!
You okay?
It's just like riding a bike.
You ready to make the jump?
Ready, Doc.
1, 2, 3, jump!
Whoa!
Nice form, buddy. Out of reception on the wireless.
Great. Where'd you get these?
From Bird's cache of 21st century video game consoles. Now remember, all you've got to do is attach the flux sync modules to those diagnostic lights.
Will do, Doc. It's locked! Is this the starboard flux emitter?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sync.
But it's getting a little bumpy out here.
about 2 to go.
Sneak past the rearview mirror. Not sure what that'll do. Flames. There's a fusion belching flames.
Yes, that's unfortunate. I'd stay out of them if I were you.
Not sure what that'll do. Not sure what that'll do. What that'll do.
Don't cross those flames, they may be radioactive.
I don't even like crossing through normal flames.
Excellent. Now let's get that muscle right, Marshall, before she starts making life difficult.
making it easy up till now?
Well, here goes nothing, Doc. Whoa!
Perfect! Now, aim the boxing towards the receiving dish on my DeLorean.
Receiving dish. Check! Is that one of the flux emitters?
Yes. Now plug in the flux sink.
I can't reach it from here. Reach it from here.
We just have to climb onto the top.
I can't reach it from here.
We just have to climb onto the top.
Fusion! Should I disable it?
Leave it alone! It's not a good idea to monkey with nuclear reactors.
It's one of the flux emitters!
I'm okay.
not touch it now that it's synced? Edna!
What?
Let me in!
You want in? Fine!
Marty, are you all right?
Not really. English, Doc.
We've got to get Edna home. Now! Hold on!
Then I must be back in... Would you be kind enough to tell me what day it is?
It's the day I place you under arrest for arson, resisting arrest, and being a general all-round pain in the ass.
No! You can't arrest me! Not now, I just got back from the last century.
Would you look at that? Edna Strickland, drunk as a skunk.
I'm not drunk, you reprobate. I'm a time traveler.
Sure you are. I'm loving this.
I'll prove it to you. Come with me. We can do the whole day over if you want. We can fix everything.
We can start by drying you out. Come on, into the station with you.
You can bunk with me, doll.
I'd rather die. Stop it! Unhand me, you dolt!
Well, I guess that's it for Edna.
Yes, I suppose it is. You know, whoever said time heals all wounds didn't know squat about time travel.
What do we do about that, DeLorean?
No need to do a thing. Ever since we synced up the time circuits, the temporal breakdown in Edna's DeLorean has accelerated at an exponential rate. By my calculations, the timeline should catch up with it in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, now!
What the hell? Hey, Parker, you're not gonna believe this!
See? What'd I say? Ready to go home?
Wait, Doc! The timeline's not fixed yet. Look!
Sonny! You missed all the fireworks at the expo!
Yeah, so I heard. Listen, I heard a rumor about you two.
I guess we gotta come clean. Ta-da! Hottie took me to Reno last night!
Try to keep a secret in Hill Valley.
Well, you gonna congratulate us or what?
Then it's true. My grandpa's married the wrong grandma. I'm done for.
Hey, you feeling all right, kid? You don't look so hot.
This just isn't right.
Now, I know marrying a Canadian for a work permit isn't strictly by the book, but hey, sometimes you gotta go out on a limb for the ones you love.
Isn't he just the sweetest?
Trixie, you can't marry Artie.
Is this about my past with Kid? 'Cause Artie ain't holding that against me.
That's right, darling. The past is the past.
Yeah, but... can you see through me?
Nope. Never could figure you out. I thought you'd be thrilled for us.
You don't understand. You're supposed to marry Sylvia Miskin.
But I did marry Sylvia Miskin.
What?
You didn't think my real name was Trixie Trotta, did ya?
Don't feel too bad. It was kind of a surprise to me, too.
Wait a minute. You're Grandma Sylvie?
Grandma? Hey, how old do you think I am, kiddo?
But you're so skinny and blonde and...
huh. Yeah, you know, it's amazing.
Oh my god, I've seen you naked. You're Sylvia?
You okay, pal?
Yeah, I'm fine. Great. You kids go off and have yourself a wonderful honeymoon. And don't worry about your dad, Artie. I'm sure he'll come around.
Come around to what?
To approving your marriage. You seem kind of mad about it back at the high school.
Well, that was before I got a look at her. Besides, as my dear old father Seamus used to say, no sense in getting riled up over something I can't do nothing about. And honestly, now that I met her, I can't imagine a better daughter-in-law than the charming Miss Sylvie here.
Aw, thank you, Dad.
As for you, stranger, I'll thank you to not go poking your nose in McFly family business.
It's been a pleasure, Agent Crockett.
See you in the funny paper, Sonny.
Goodbye, Grandma.
You know, I took some pictures of Trixie in 1931.
Hey, that's my grandma you're talking about.
Here we are, back in good old 1986.
May 14th?
15th. Best to build in a little lag time. Gives you a chance to catch up.
Looks like the estate sale is still going on. Hey, don't you want to stay, Doc? You gotta stop the bank from selling off all your old stuff.
What are you talking about? Estate sale? Bank? I'm not dead, Marty. Clara and I are having a little garage sale, that's all.
Garage sale? You mean...
Marty, you're back from your trip. Hello, Doc. Selling off the family treasures, eh?
Not quite, but I hope you find something you like.
Speaking of which, did you find what you were looking for?
Yeah, I sure did.
Great! Hey, is that a box of Asimov?
Let me get this straight. Are you telling me you live here now? In 1986?
Well, naturally. Claire and I maintain a part-time residence here. Wasn't that the case when you left?
No.
Strange. I can't imagine not sticking around. After all, I've got my late father's foundation to supervise. If I wasn't here, who'd present the annual Earhart Brown Scholarship for Young Scientists? Something funny?
I'll explain it to you later.
I don't see what's so funny about looking after a family legacy. Oh, almost forgot. I've got something for you. Happy graduation.
Graduation? But that's not for another... The McFlys of Hill Valley.
An exhaustively detailed history of your family. From your great-great-grandfather Seamus to the present.
You traveled through time to write this?
Well, most of the research was done traditionally, but your grandma Sylvia proved to be something of a mystery.
Which is why you traveled back to 1931, to look for her.
Exactly. Who knew she was singing in a speakeasy under her stage name?
This is great, Doc. Thanks.
It's the least I could do for the man who saved me from making the worst mistake of my life.
Yoo-hoo! Dr. Brown!
Edna? Einy!
What's going on? What are you doing on my door?
The same thing I do every afternoon, silly man. Giving him such much-needed exercise. Isn't that right, Einstein?
Hey, Dollface, it's past time for our 3:30.
Coming, sweetie! Oh, Mr. McFly, have you seen my stepson anywhere?
Oh, Biff, I think you're late for an appointment.
Oh, gosh, you're right, Mr. McFly. Hi, Marty.
Don't they make a great little family? You'd never know they met in prison.
Don't say anything. Let's just walk quietly into the lab and hope there are no more surprises.
Future.
Marty, you can't be here. If your younger self sees you, the consequences could be catastrophic.
My younger self? Oh, right. Bring him along, too. This concerns all of us.
What do you mean? Does something happen to us?
Do we turn into assholes or something?
Nah, we're fine. But our great-great-grandkids?
What the hell?
Great Scott.
Doc, you gotta come back with me. Don't listen to him, Doc. It's me you gotta help. If you want to save Jennifer and our 12 kids...
What?
That timeline was overwritten 5 jumps back.
Doc, Jennifer's out of how can there be 2 more of me here?
I have no idea. My own rights of space-time continuum should be tearing apart like a cheap dish rag right now.
It already is. What my evil twin and I are trying to say is the future is totally jacked up, and you gotta come with me to save it. No, me!
So... We meet at last. You've altered my timeline once too often. What's going on, Doc?
Well, we do seem to have a conundrum on our hands. Or three.
Yeah, Doc, but which one is the real me?
Isn't it obvious, Marty? Come on!
Prepare to be erased. Doc, wait! What about the space-time continuum?
Yeah, what about my future?
And mine?
The future can wait. We've got a present to catch up with.
Where to, Doc?
Mr. McFly, thrill me.